The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. If you are thinking about experimenting with marijuana, pot, weed, then you should watch this video first, right? You need to understand, I'm not going to tell you the, difficult medical points of this problem. I'm going to explain you how and why it affects your brain and future, right? It's very simple, right? See, your brain has a system of giving you rewards, a reward system which is driven by a neurotransmitter called dopamine. So whenever you do something good, achieve something, your brain secretes this dopamine and then you feel good, then you feel like a reward. It same thing happens during an orgasm, during something which sometimes when somebody actually gives you a compliment or when you feel good about something very, very nice. That's a reward system because of which you basically cope with this difficult world, a complicated world, because of which you are able to learn, you develop your IQ and you basically have all these skills in your life. So this reward system must have some stimulating points and some inhibiting factors. So here the main inhibiting factor of this dopamine driven reward system is a GABA neurotransmitter, which has a GABA neuron basically in the brain. So what happens when you take weed or marijuana, that there is a component in it which is THC, which directly crosses the blood-brain barrier and reaches your brain, and it basically inhibits this GABA neurons, which is basically inhibiting the dopamine reward system, so therefore activating your reward system endlessly until that particular medicine is there, right? So if this drug is there, then you are having that reward system on, and it can be so fast, such a rewarding thing that nothing in this world can compare with the reward which you are getting by this medicine. But it might sound good, but it is very, very dangerous in the sense that after this, if you are using this repeatedly, you will not get that pleasure from any other thing which you were getting before, right? You will not get pleasures from small achievements in life, somebody giving you any compliments, somebody doing something good for you, or even an orgasm or any kind of good sex. You will not get any pleasure in that, right? Because you are getting a much higher pleasure from this particular drug. So that is a wrong thing. That's why it affects your mind, affects your thinking in a long term, affects your memory, affects your learning capability, etc., etc., etc. So that's why it's not a good thing. But let's understand what happens when you actually take this particular thing. See, number one thing, in a short term way, if you have just tried this, number one thing, you might get relaxed, you might get sleepiness, but it basically gives you a huge kind of euphoria. And this euphoria is also associated with hunger. It increases your appetite. And then you basically sleep. The signs are, if you basically have a huge dose of this, then you will also have short-term memory problems. You will have dry mouth, increased heartbeat, increased perspiration. There will be decreased balance, confusion. There can be lack of decision making in that sign. Red eye can be there. Red short eye can be there. Right? Those all things are there. And even some serious side effects like acute psychosis, delirium, paranoia, hallucinations can happen in a long, big dose of if you take it in a high dose. Number one. And what happens if you are already having an addiction and you take a, because what happens as you keep on taking it regularly, you require a higher and higher dose to achieve the same results, and it takes time for this particular effect to kick in, right? Especially if you are eating it, then it takes 30 minutes. If you are smoking it, it takes a few minutes. But every time you use it, it will take more and more time and more dosage. And therefore, people land up with an acute overdose, and which can actually increase your chances of having complications. Complications like a sudden high blood pressure with a huge cluster headache, it can lead to chest pain, heart attacks, strokes, and even seizure disorder. Sudden collapse can happen. Patients can land up in an emergency very easily. Now, these things are serious problems. Even not, if not chronically, then in the long-term way also, in the long-term, if you're not having any problem in this thing, then long-term, you'll face challenges in keeping, remembering things in your memory, in learning new stuff, in actually thinking about thinking problem. You will have thinking problems also, and you will also have breathing problems if you are smoking pot or smoking this marijuana, and problems with, if you are a female, then you will definitely have problems with pregnancy in future. So these are all bad stuff, and obviously chances of increased heart attack even in young age, etc., etc. This is wrong. So what can be done, right? Obviously, first you need to understand the signs of addiction. This is addictive. Obviously, addiction signs are that you become more and more irritable, you have trouble sleeping, you have trouble, you have decreased appetite now, and you have anxiety as well as more and more cravings of different things, right? If you're having these things, then what's possible, you are addicted. And if you land up in an emergency, don't worry, because the most important point here is that there is a very small number of people who end up dying with this thing, but then it can lead to a serious problem in your life in future. You won't be achieving the heights which you should have, or even your IQ would be reduced if you are taking it regularly. Then right now, if you are having any kind of overdose, intoxication, then the most important point here is to prevent injuries, because it's possible you can injure yourself or others. And panic situation needs to be controlled, because you might be in a panic and your attendants, your relatives might be in a panic. That's why first thing is to calm the situation and calm you down. That's why doctors give you more sedatives, like sleeping medications, sedative benzodiazepines, like medicines. So first target is to calm the situation and then assess. If you are having problem breathing, then breathing support is given. If you have taken it through mouth, then charcoal, activated charcoal can be given, so that maybe a little bit of drug will not get absorbed, etc. And even gastric lavage can be done if it is acute. If it has not been 30 minutes or 1 hour of taking it. And then blood tests, breathing support, chest x-rays, ECG, EEGs, then IV fluids can be given. Then according to your symptoms, medicines will be given in the emergency as well as in the hospital. But then if you are having severe complications, heart attacks, other things, then obviously the whole situation changes and the complication starts. That's why it's not a good thing to even try this once, because one time exposure of a very highly rewarding event will actually take the edge off of every other rewards system from your life, every other event which will happen, which will give you the pleasure. So don't experiment with this thing. It's not something which you or any child, any teenager should experiment. Please make sure to share this video with everyone. This is important, and that's why it's your duty to do this. I'm Dr. Paramjeet. You're watching Dr. Education. Stay connected.